want to tell you something about what is coming. We want to tell you about mysteries concerning the wisdom of God. Shabra lekoto manada. Peluze mene kumbra ze maniko palasias. In the name of Jesus. May you be blessed as you listen to the word of God. Beloved, it is why that you listen to the wisdom of God, what God is bringing, and what the ways that you can be saved. It is very, very crucial. Within this time, you need to listen to the wisdom of God. Amen. Today, I want to share with you a small topic, very brief and precise, very concise. I wouldn't waste my time today, so lend me your ears very well so that you can listen to whatever I'm about to share. Amen. Let me thank you for the grace given unto us. Paul says something. He said, if I'm able to proclaim the gospel, then I do not post upon myself because necessity is laid upon me. As I'm about to share that word, as I'm about to bring that word forward, as I'm about to begin the pruning process, I pray that God may every stony heart be leveled in the name of Jesus. I pray that God may you speak to men so that they will transform, they'll come back to you in the name of Jesus. This is the time for reconciliation. This is the time for all men to be drawn unto Him. For the Bible says that if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto myself. We are here to proclaim the word. I pray that may you strengthen me. I subdue every spirit within the atmosphere, every spirit of impedance by the power of the Holy Ghost. I pray and suppress that in the name of Jesus. All authority and power has been conferred unto us by Christ in the name of Jesus. I suppress every negativity. I pray that God may there be silent before thy word. May that listen to the word. That's all. So that there will be a transformation in the name of Jesus. Amen. Today I want to share with you a topic called the crucified man. The crucified man. Amen. This topic is very interesting. The crucified man. I want to pick our prime scripture from Galatians 2:20, where Paul said that I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ that liveth in me. Amen. Beloved, I want you to understand that there is a kind of life that you ought to live as a believer. And this is the kind of life, the Bible says that we should live according to the patterns, we shouldn't live according to the patterns of this world, but we should live according to the teachings of the spiritual things. We should live according to the spirit. Man. Amen. So today, I want to tell you something about what we are calling the spiritual man, the carnal man and the natural man. Amen. So Paul said, if I am crucified with Christ, nevertheless I live, yet not I, but Christ that liveth in me. Beloved, to be crucified with Christ, a man who has been crucified with Christ is the man who has accepted Christ as his personal savior, as a man who is born again, as a man who has been regenerated, as a man who moves with God, as a man who is being directed by the directions of the Holy Spirit. This is what we are calling the crucified man. So any man who is led by the Holy Spirit is called the crucified man. Anyone who has accepted Christ as a personal savior is known as the crucified man. Anyone who wants to be led by the Holy Spirit is called the crucified man. Amen. So the Bible says that there is this kind of man called the natural man. He is a kind of man who does not believe in any spiritual things. The Bible says that Paul said, those things, those people, they do not believe anything that cometh from God. They do not receive anything that cometh from the Spirit. They are living according to their own conscience. They are living according to their own abilities. They are living according to their own fallacies. They are living according to their own promises and according to their own wisdom. They do not believe anything that is spiritual. That is the natural man. But I can tell you that 70% of us within this era are living the natural man. We do not believe in the spiritual things. We do not believe anything concerning spiritual things. We do not believe anything from God. We do not receive, we don't want to receive anything. We don't want to even hear anything according to the practice of the Spirit. are classified as the natural man. They do not believe in anything that you do. They do not believe that even God exists. They do not believe that there is a kind of life that you ought to live to please your maker. They do not believe in all those things. They think it is just a fallacy. They believe that yes, there was someone who just created the universe. There was someone who just created the sea, the animals within, and the humans and the plants, and they have fallacies that even the sun and the moon, they all appeared and they were just there, and everything is natural and they don't care. That is the natural man. But the Bible is saying that you have to accept Christ so that you will be regenerated. You can be born again. You can be filled with the Spirit so that your maker can now talk to your conscience. Your maker can now nature. Your maker can now make your conscience and all that within you be purified so that you'll be able to understand that there is a kind of God who created you, and therefore you must worship that kind of God. We are talking about the natural man. About 70% of us are natural men. We only believe things that our mind tells us. We believe in our conscience. We don't believe in the things of God. We don't believe that there is a day coming called Judgment Day. We don't believe that we'll even die, even though they know that they will die. But they don't believe. They know it's natural. But trust me, there is a kind of life that you ought to live to please your maker. Therefore, you need to be a spiritual man instead of a natural man. Amen. Now, there is a difference between this spiritual man and the natural man. The natural man, in between the spiritual man and the natural man, is what we are calling the carnal man. Now, the carnal man, Paul has called them as what we call in the pure. They are faith in Christ. They have been born again, but they are not doing according to the things of the Spirit. They are not led by the Spirit. They do things according to their fleshly desires. They are called the chaos.